either way.
Well, I mean, if he can land it, if he can land the reset. He puts his hand up, he gets the reset. Can he stun? Can he stun the Triana so no immunity? He puts his hand up. Is that the secret? Put your hand up.
And you get it.
Lure with the... Oh my gosh, that's a new strat. Put your hand up and you land whatever you want to land. Here we go. Helena time, baby. As I like to say, swaying play. He's going to put his hand up again.
Is the pony
going to... He puts his hand up. Okay. He does this at home, I bet.
Yeah. In the bath.
Oh, here we go. Here we go. Is he?
Is Helena
going to... Is he going to put his hand up again to try to get a proc? Go for the stun. Gets the stun and the proc. No hands up. Oh, it's very interesting now. This is not looking good. Anytime you get this, he's very happy. He's very happy for this.
He's looking nervous though.
Does he get the defense breakout to Triana again? He's going to be able to control here if he wants to.
Does he get sleep for her? Yeah, he goes for the sleeping side.
He gets the fire! Wow! This is going to be... Oh my gosh. This is not looking good. He can go ahead and kill whatever units he wants.
Yeah, he's definitely gonna kill this monkey here.
He can even proc the Triana's passive if he likes. Yeah, that's totally fine. He's in full control. He's in absolute full control. He's thinking about, does he want to do it? No, Chase takes his shield. Hey, playing it safe here. Landing attack down. That's gonna reduce the damage greatly. Monkey King is going to be able to heal here with the second skill.
I don't think he gets through the shield. Gets a fire.
Gets a stun, okay. That's a step one.
He's losing the death break. It's kind of key. Still wants to go for the kill.
Now, do you go for Rain of Stones? I think you do. Honestly, I wouldn't actually mind Rain of Stones here. Getting the attack buff, attack bar. Oh, I guess it didn't matter if it heals. Yeah.
Killing that Genny there. Living is on there. Does he go sleep for him, Triana? He got it.
Gets a Violet. The Violet not only just does a little bit more damage, adds those debuffs, but really reduces the cooldowns that they have.
Ooh, almost one-shot at Garrow there.
Goodness.
The 1 HP again.
This is literally a 1 HP tournament. Puts his hand up, gets the reset.
Does he go for a stun on Sharon here, though? Yes, he does it.
Gets that damage out.
And now, stun, first kill, Triana.
He just has to go for a stun. You don't have another option. And didn't put your hand up high enough this time, Lure. Gets the attack down again. The revenge, okay. That's going to help out a little bit here.
Okay, I'm stunning here. The thing is, does this Garo go before the monkey? I don't think so. That means the monkey can finish them. He goes.
Garo before.
Wow. Now he can't kill the Garo anymore.
No, he cannot. This is looking really bad for TAHN-DU. He's getting the procs, but it's not going to do much here.
But too late.
Helena, if she just gets that extra rotation, two rotations can really set up.
Yeah. Directly in turn one as well. Yeah.
At this point, I mean, let's just see Helena do things.
Let's just see.
Yeah, see, he put his hand up. That's guaranteed. That's guaranteed he's going to land on the defense break. Now, he did get an additional turn, so we're not going to see Helena proc after this because of the additional turn that he got. He gets just a salt in the wound.
Yeah.
I mean, actually, I don't know if it's salt anymore. It might be salt and lemon and lime and all that stuff into the wound right here.
Everything.
My goodness.
Yeah, TAHN just taking his time here. This match is over.
He's just really thinking about what he's going to do. He's taking his time. Very smart. He's thinking about his next match.
Because when those land, it's going to get really hard for Lure.
All right, let's see it here. This is...
But anyways, Helena is almost useless here.
Yeah, that's what I was about to say. He doesn't get it. This is looking really bad. Now, he doesn't actually have to reset the Oki if he doesn't want to. He has plenty of immunity to do whatever he likes. Chooses to reset the Fengyan, preventing the revenge and that heal to come up.
Gonna sleep Sarin? Yeah, he got it.
Can't sleep at the Sarin. I'm telling you, man, with the control setup right here, TAHN-DU might never move again.
It's gonna get into this. Is gonna be a long match. That's one thing for sure.
Oh yeah! Once we get to the part where the attack goes up, the HP goes down. Oh my gosh! Lands a two-turn sleep. Are you ready for TOA Heart? Stage 100. Here it is. Welcome to stage
100.
100 of TOA Heart. Here we go.
They're the rest of the lane now, but the lane is not going to do much as long as there's immunity on there.
Oh my gosh. I mean, the sleep doesn't matter. I mean, the only thing that allows him to do is he's now able to potentially change targets onto the unit that he would like to actually kill first.
But who is he going to kill here?
Thando's really hoping for some violent proximities.
Does he get a sleep again?
This is going to be Omega Resident Sleeper for this match for a little while here, sir.
Immunity back up.
Here comes the play. Yeah, we're just going to have to wait until the damage. He's just waiting. Lure's like, I just got to play my cards right, wait for my damage to increase, and all my units will start doing plenty of damage.
Got the fire proc from Gany.
Look at the damage. It's a slow tick of damage. See this? Boom. 2,000. It's just slow chippings. Yeah.
But still, in the end, he needs to kill that Feng Yang.
Well, if he doesn't use it, okay, I was about to say, if he doesn't use that, he's giving the Thando 3 unit opportunities to violent proc out. Yeah. My gosh, he's landing every sleep potentially possible.
I have to agree with you now. I'm more on your side. Lures,
it's
really
the control. Like, how do you wake up?
Yeah, but he's landing all the sleeps here.
I mean, he lands the sleeps, but he's still going after the same target. Yeah, 500, 500.
Yeah, those other guys, none of them gets turned on, none of them can fire proc. They don't do anything.
No. And even, let's say something violent procs, what's going to happen? He's got immunity up. Feng Yang's not going to land defense break. He's got the immunity up. Tsarin, Helena, they do nothing. This is in total control. I told you, that last turn was Thando's last move. Oh, okay, he does move again there.
Well, what could he have done different? Fire Monkey instead of Feng Yang? Fire Monkey Raccoon?
Fire Monkey, if Thando does have Fire Monkey, and he already preemptively knew that Lure is going to be playing that Hathor comp, because he did pick Raccoon, right? So he kind of had a feeling this would happen. He needed another unit to counter out this comp, or he had to ban Hathor. He had to ban out this potential comp.
He's probably just going to reset. Down here, yeah. Feng Yang is still reset, didn't get a turn yet, so it's quite safe.
You know, I guess it's scarier to allow... He did ban Lure's Perna, right? It's a little bit scarier to allow Perna through, but maybe it's a better chance than sleeping forever here. I would say that's definitely one of two units that whenever I see it, I really think to myself, can I let it through or not? Hathor and Amelia. Units that are just so hard to deal with sometimes, at least for me.
It is, especially getting Arthur is super strong and then Busan next to it.
I mean, Thando's getting punished for not having any immunity. You know, I mean, Gany Hathor is a really, really strong comp, but there are a lot of ways to pick against it.
I do feel like Thando's not that lucky as well. I mean, like, every sleep is landing right now, and he even picked the rest of it.
Right.
I think only one sleep from Arthur so far.
Yeah. I mean, that was with taking the resist lead, like you said, right? But I mean, 55 accuracy onto 41 resist.
Yeah, but I'm pretty sure Pekka's... Fun, like, what I've seen from him is most of his units are a bit hybrid build, like HP and defense, and also have good rest and currency.
Yeah.
So, it's pretty much probably a lot of 80, 90% rest on all his units, but everything is just legend.
Lure looking so happy about this match. Yeah. Gotta look how much damage this Lusa will do. Look, skill 2. 2,000. Okay, that's quite underwhelming, but when you do 2,000 20 times, I mean, like, what's worse? Never hitting or hitting for 1 damage every time?
That's true. Even hitting the sleep from Triana on Helena.
That is definitely not a crit damage Lusa, though. 2K was very low. I was expecting a little more. We didn't get that far in the match, I guess.
You even got me excited to see, like,
yeah,
10k.
it was slow too, right? Oh my.
Oh, see, let me sleep again. Tech bar production, though. Look at him, yes.
Always with the hand up. I think I might do that from now on. I gotta throw the hand up every time.
He already knows it's in the pocket. Probably just reset Fang here. Fang was fire proc, so he got his second skill up.
Good night. Can Panda do it?
It's already 60%.
It's one of the units I... Oh my gosh.
That Panda.
He does have to wake it up, but still. He's just never moving.
Even if he does. There's immunity, there's shield.
If you're Lure, you gotta be really excited here, man. You're taking down the second place player from last year's tournament. That's big. That's huge. He doesn't even skill one. He uses delayed promise one more time. Hello?
Go back to sleep. There it is.
Did he land asleep too?